Happy holidays, everyone. Merry Christmas, happy December, whatever you're celebrating this year. Happy celebration. Anyway, this is the last video before Christmas. I can't believe how fast December went by. I'm afraid if I blink right now, I'm going to wake up 30 years later, old and gray, and just all my life passed by in a flash. Time's going so fast when you're an adult. What's going on?
If you know the answer, give me your secrets.
So anyway, today I want to share something with you that is very essential and important for my workflow as a digital artist, and that is my top 5 favorite shortcuts. And no, it's not the big reveal control set in the end. Duh. I'll show you how these shortcuts work, why I have them, and I'm going to show you how to set them up in Photoshop and in Medibang. But first, a shout out to this video's sponsor, Skillshare. I actually realized when writing the script for this video that Skillshare has been supporting my channel continuously for almost a year now. I'm super, super grateful for their support, and I get a feeling that you guys are also happy about all the free trials that you get for their site. So in the unlikely events that you have never heard of Skillshare before on this channel, here's the drill. Skillshare is an online learning platform with heavy focus on art and creators. There are thousands of classes, and you can learn anything from having a productive and creative lifestyle to managing a life as a freelance artist, or just learn how to master a certain medium. I recently made a Goals for 2020 playlist on my account. I collected some of the classes I unfortunately didn't have time for in 2019, along with some new and exciting ones that I found, and made a playlist. My favorite class of 2019 was this class on digital landscapes and environments by Hardy Fowler. I was so inspired after taking this class, and I even started to sketch environments for my characters. I cannot recommend this class enough, and of course I'll put a link to it in the description so you can easily find it. With a Skillshare Premium membership, you get access to all of their classes, class resources, and also their workshops. You can submit your own projects to classes for feedback, or you can just check out the projects that other students have done. And once again, I'm offering 2 free months of Skillshare Premium. Just follow the link in the description below and claim your free months today. And if you can't get enough of Skillshare after the trial runs out, the annual membership is less than $10 a month. Thank you guys so much for listening. Now back to the video. So first, let's get the very obvious shortcuts out of the way. This isn't that kind of video where I in the end reveal that Control Set is in fact my favorite shortcut of all time, leaving all of you guys probably feeling pretty anticlimactic over the fact that Control Set just is the most amazing invention in the history of digital art. I consider those shortcuts pretty essential, and I think all digital artists who work with shortcuts should use these. So there's really no need to spend too much time on them, so let's just get them out of the way, shall we? There's Control Set, also known as Undo, that just undoes your latest actions. It's kind of like playing the digital art god, where you get to decide which mistakes will live and which never existed in the first place. Then there is Control Alt Set, which undoes and redoes your last action. So if you made a stroke and you're not sure if you want it to be there or not, you can use Control Alt Set to watch it before and after for infinity. Then there's B, which activates the brush tool. There's E, that activates the eraser. And then there's I, which is the color picker or the eyedropper tool. That if you hit I, you will select the tool, but if you hold down Alt instead, you only select it temporarily, and then returning to the previous tool when letting go of Alt. This is very helpful when you're blending colors together, because you can easily pick them up by holding Alt and keep painting when you let go with your brush tool. Then there is Zoom In and Out, and the traditional way to do it is hold Control and then use plus and minus, but there's also another very intuitive way to do it. You press Z and the right mouse button, and then move to the left and the right to zoom in and out. This way you only take up one express key on your tablet for zooming in and out. And the last essential shortcut is the spacebar or the hand tool. It allows you to move around on the canvas. Hold spacebar down or map it to a button on your stylus to quickly navigate around on your canvas. If you have a tablet with very few express keys, I suggest using the keyboard for the essential shortcuts. Why not map the essential shortcuts to your tablet's few express keys? I think we should save those express keys for more advanced shortcuts that are harder to perform on a keyboard with one hand. If you don't use a keyboard along with your tablet, then I suggest mapping these essential shortcuts to your express keys. Now let's move on to the 5 shortcuts that I use religiously in my workflow. Number 1, Flip Canvas. I've mentioned this feature a few times throughout my time here on YouTube. Flipping the canvas lets your eye see a drawing from a new angle and perspective, and you can much easier spot little mistakes. Some artists use it all the time while they're painting, and other artists, like myself, use it not as often, but often enough to just check if anything needs corrections. On my keyboard, I have this shortcut mapped to F2. To set this up in Photoshop, go to Edit and enter the keyboard shortcuts. And scroll down until you see the Flip Canvas Horizontal. Click the shortcut column and press the desired shortcut key. Be aware though that even though you might want the shortcut to be on your tablet's Express keys, you still need to set it up as a keyboard shortcut, since that is the key that your tablet will refer to when you set up the Express keys. When you're done, hit Accept and then OK. Now you can flip your canvas with a single tap on your keyboard. In Medibang, go to File and enter the shortcut settings. Now in Medibang, there are 2 ways that you can flip your canvas. You can either flip the entire canvas and the contents, or you can just flip the view. The main difference is that the view only flips it temporarily. Even if you forgot to flip it back and saved up the image, it would remember its original direction. If you flip the entire canvas with its contents and then export the image, you get the new flipped image exported. Just flipping the view takes less effort for the computer, so that is what I'll be setting up, but choose whatever you prefer. Flipping the canvas with its contents is here in the Edit tab. The view flip is down here in the View tab. In my Medibang, it's already mapped to the Down key. I'll just keep it there and instead set the Flip Canvas with Contents to F2, so it's like in Photoshop. Shortcut number 2, changing the brush size. This is a shortcut that I didn't actually use until earlier this year, and it has really, really sped up my workflow and made it more smooth. Now there are several ways to do this, but first we need to set up the shortcut. In Photoshop, go back to the Shortcuts menu. This time, make sure you show the shortcuts for Tools. Scroll all the way down to the bottom, and then a bit up again until you see the Decrease Brush Size and Increase Brush Size. As a default, they're usually mapped to the square brackets left and right, but on a lot of computers, that's a pretty stupid shortcut because you would need to hold Alt to access those shortcuts. I mapped mine to Pause and Comma, even though they were already in use by default. I just accepted to overwrite the shortcut. Hit Accept and then OK. In Medibang, go to the Shortcut settings and down into the Others tab. Here is the shortcuts for your brush size. Map them to the desired keys and hit OK. There's another way that you can easily control your brush size. On Windows, hold down Alt and the right mouse and drag left and right to control the size of the brush. It's kind of like the thing I explained before with the zooming in and out, but this time with the Alt key. And on Mac, you hold the Control and Option and drag left and right. I have right click mapped to the button of my stylus, so I just need to press Alt on the keyboard and the button on my stylus and then move it to either side to change the brush size. And here's a little quick tip for you. If you move up and down, you control the brush's hardness as well. You're welcome. Shortcut number 3, transformation tool. I use the transformation tool a lot. I mean a lot when I draw. To move around stuff and rescale stuff, especially in sketch stages or if I need to resize or rotate parts of my drawing. I usually make a selection with the lasso tool first to select the parts of the drawing that I want to alter and then use the transformation tool to change my selection. The default shortcut for this tool is Ctrl T or Command T on Mac, but if you'd like to set it to something else, be my guest. By default, it's the same shortcut in Medibang, and with this shortcut it just gets so much faster and easier to rotate stuff, flip stuff, scale stuff, whatever you need, move stuff. The fourth shortcut might be considered a little odd to some of you. It's a shortcut to the fill menu. This is a neat little shortcut that I like to use. It's a shortcut that fills in color. Sometimes I need to quickly fill an area with a solid color, and by using the shortcut, which is Shift plus F5 or Shift plus Backspace on Mac, quickly opens the window and lets me decide from some default fill colors. In Medibang, the default shortcut for fill is the Insert key on Windows, and actually I'm not sure what it is on Mac. Just be aware that it doesn't open a fill window in Medibang, but just immediately fills your entire canvas or selection with the color that you have selected. And the last shortcut is Rotate. In Photoshop, you can rotate your canvas to any angle, which sometimes just makes it easier to perform certain strokes or paint from certain angles. The Rotate tool in Photoshop works the same way as the Flip Canvas on a View basis in Medibang that we talked about before. It doesn't actually rotate the canvas and its contents, but just the view that you're seeing it from. By default, the Rotate tool is mapped to R in Photoshop. While rotating, you can hold down Shift to snap to certain angles. This is especially helpful when you want to return to the original rotation. In Medibang, there isn't a rotation tool per se, but you can still rotate the rotation view like when you are flipping the canvas. As default, rotation to the left and right are mapped to the left and right keys on your keyboard. To reset the rotation, hit the up key. And as far as I understand, in Medibang, you can only rotate in increments and not continuously like in Photoshop. Now, how do you get these shortcuts down on your tablet's Express keys? Open whatever tablet settings you have for your tablet. I'm using an XP Pen right now. While their shortcut settings are not as intuitive as on Wacom settings, I still think this one is fairly easy to understand, and I have definitely tried much worse. I mean, seriously, sometimes those Express key setups can be a nightmare to try to figure out. All you gotta do is to remember the shortcuts that you set up in your drawing program and map the same shortcuts here. A little tip, keep in mind which shortcuts you used most and also importantly, which you often use together. For instance, I often use B, which is the brush, and I, the color picker, together when I'm blending. So I want these two keys to be close to each other so I can easily shift between them. Shortcuts I use less, like the transformation tool, will be mapped to a key I don't often use or that I would require my other hand to reach. And if you have a lot of Express keys, you might need some memory help to remember where they're all located, especially in the beginning. I put small stickers on my keys to visualize my shortcuts so I don't forget. And one last thing, in case you have a tablet with one of those cool rocket rings or touch panels which allows you to add more than one shortcut to it, you can map the brush shortcuts to this Express quote-unquote key. I have a ring on my tablet, and by making it increase the brush with the shortcut pause or dot when it goes in one direction and then decrease its size with comma in the other direction, I can control my brush size simply using this ring. This has been a real game changer in my workflow, but if you don't have such a ring or a touch feel, just use the other shortcut that I showed you and you will be perfectly fine as well. And lastly, here is the complete overview of my shortcuts on my current tablet. I have a lot of Express keys, more than I can actually find shortcuts for, but my tablet also takes up all of the space on my desk and it's impossible to use the keyboard while I use the tablet. So I need to have all of my shortcuts on the tablet. Even start and stop record buttons for when I'm recording my painting processes on here. So we're about to wrap it up and I hope you liked this video, found it useful, or just got an even deeper insight into my workflow as a digital artist. If you liked it, please leave a thumbs up. It really means the world to my channel. It helps more than you think. And leave a comment down below telling me and the rest of the world your favorite shortcut. And no, you are not allowed to mention the essentials like Control Z. You can do better than that. I believe in you. And remember to claim your 2 months of free trial on Skillshare Premium with the link in the description below. All that's left to say now, guys, is Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, Merry December, Go Yule, Feliz Navidad. I hope you have a wonderful evening, Christmas Day, with your family, friends, whoever you want to celebrate it with, regardless of your beliefs and whatever you're celebrating. I just hope you have a wonderful couple of days. I'll see you on the other side of Christmas.